Tonight, we lower the lights to enjoy two films courtesy of the 48-Hour Film Project Miami. But first, we visit the Institute of Contemporary Art Miami to experience Pedro Reyes' Sanatorium. In this performative project, Reyes combines interpretations of psychology with art. Guided by therapists, we're encouraged to look within and to contribute to this transient exhibition's regional adaptation. Take a look.
Sanatorium is a landmark presentation because it involves an entirely new type of performance. For this installation, Pedro has trained 25 volunteers from the local community and asked them to participate by learning one of his 8 to 10 treatments. Every person who comes into the installation gets an entirely fresh experience, which is dictated by their interaction with the volunteers. Pedro Reyes is an artist from Mexico, still based in Mexico City to this day, a leading artist of his generation. We call him a sculptor. As you'll see from the exhibition, he takes a pretty innovative approach to sculpture. His work across disciplines and across media has to do with the relationship between people and the relationship between objects and the way that sculpture can alter those relationships. Each of Pedro Reyes' treatments combines strategies for healing or for alternative forms of knowing from different traditions. So you'll see throughout each of the treatments, each of which is entirely distinct, elements of the Catholic tradition, things like catharsis and confession, as well as elements from Greek tragedy, Roman philosophy and oratory, etc., through the gamut, as well as more traditional forms of psychoanalysis like that of Freud and Lacan. My favorite is gudu, for a number of reasons. Gudu, for those of you who have not done the treatment, is a good version of voodoo. In that treatment, you choose 5 charms, which are essentially industrially produced. They could really mean anything. They're endlessly interpretable. And you affix them to a doll of your choosing. You decorate them and you assign them based on the area of the body where you're applying it, different forms of meaning. Then you press down upon it in order to make sure that person is really experiencing the goodwill that you're giving to them. It is a really meaningful experience for everybody who enters that room. Additionally, everybody's invited to take the doll home. This idea of gifting an object or a sculpture is another theme that runs throughout this installation and is felt most presently in that particular piece. The Museum of Hypothetical Lifetimes is a place where you can chart your own past, present, and future. So using the props which you see on the shelf behind me, you place them within different terrains or zones which are identified in what you've called a maze. And there, using identifications both on the prop and the geography of the maze, you create a story of your own lifetime. City Leaks is a very fun treatment at the sanatorium, and one of the quickest actually, but one of the most cathartic, and it is in fact the one that's quoting traditional forms of confession the most literally. Every person who enters that particular treatment is meant to write down their deepest, darkest secret, tie it up with a bow, and leave it in the bottle. Then they're able to take another secret from someone who they don't know, or they don't know that they know, who hasn't identified themselves, pull it out of the bottle and read it. That person again is able to take that secret with them if they like a fortune from a fortune cookie. When commissioning or installing a work which is so demanding of visitors and which doesn't present traditional pretty pictures on the wall, you expect the first question for everybody to, or the first response for every visitor to come in to put their hands on their hips and say, why is this art? Which is a question that we're fully equipped to answer and happy to address, and in fact, the simplest questions can be some of the most productive. However, we've had a really sophisticated range of responses to the work. People have really enjoyed being greeted by the volunteers, and even seeing some of the members of the community who they might know in another context through this installation. ICA Miami specializes in presenting the most experimental art of our time. What we really do through our exhibitions, through our catalogs and our public programs, as well as education, is highlight scholarship, on the most important, both emerging, that's young, and underrepresented established artists of our time. So not only those artists who are producing new work, but also those artists who've been working for decades and have yet to receive, in an American or international context, the type of recognition that they deserve.
For information about this and current exhibitions, visit icamiami.org. There's more to come right here on Art Loft.